You heard Alex Fast on the call. They need every point, and that they do. Take a look at the Minnesota Wild in that Western Conference wild card standings race. They certainly helped out their cause last night with a crucial two-point overtime victory in what was a very dramatic finish and something that everybody's talking about this afternoon. So only appropriate that we welcome in the head coach of the Minnesota Wild, John Hynes, to join the conversation. John, good to see you. You know, I guess I just have to go back, and everybody wants to know, like, what was going through your mind when you made the decision to pull Marc-Andre Fleury?
Yeah, sure. It's great to see you guys, too. And Boiler, it's been a while. So, Dave, good to see you, too. Yeah, you know, it was something that we had talked about a little bit after the Colorado game, just if we get into situations where, you know, two points is really important for us. And we had discussed, you know, the possibility of doing it at some point in overtime to get 2 points. And then last night, the opportunity presented itself. And, you know, sometimes you can make decisions like that, but I give, you know, Kirill and he was kind of the guy that set it up, you know, when Flower was going to come. I thought Kirill's sense on the ice of just kind of waiting until we can get the line changed the right way and putting those four guys on the ice in that situation with their power play acumen just gives you the confidence as a coach that you feel like you can get something done in that situation.
Well, Hynesy, I was fortunate enough to play with you for 2 years, and you were always so prepared. I've already admitted once on the show, I did not know the actual rule on that. If they had scored, you get 0 points. But I love, we'll call it the bravery of it, or whatever you want to think of at home. Yeah. Now, were you guys working this four-man offensive unit? Because normally 4-on-3, at least you'd throw one D out there. I don't know how, I haven't watched close enough on 4-on-3s for you guys. But is it always a 4-on-3 with all forwards, or was this just for this special occasion you really needed one?
No, you know what, Boiler? It's on our 5-on-3, it's 5 forwards.
Love it.
And then just take one off. Yeah, and then you take one off. You know, obviously Hartman is usually the guy in the 5-on-3 too, but he wound up coming off. So, you know, like I said, I think sometimes, you know, it is a little bit, you know, of a decision where we felt like, I just think the chemistry and the ability of those guys in those power play situations, 5-on-3, 4-on-3, you know, you look at the pass that Zouk made that, you know, we had full possession. And I think, it may be different if you don't have the confidence of those guys in those situations to make that call. But, you know, we felt like we were going to go for it. We told them after Nashville scored late, and then we went into the overtime during the, you know, when they're making the ice or cleaning the ice for the OT, we kind of prepped the players a little bit. And it was funny because they wanted to do it right away. We're like, we had to hold them back a little bit. So it's like, they're like, we going now? We going now? What are we doing? I'm like, no, just hold on and see if we can, let's give it a chance to develop. But to be honest with you, if the players don't execute and you don't have the confidence, you know, that they can do it, then maybe you don't make the decision. So it's a credit to those guys.
Interesting, John. You just finished saying you discussed it while they were cleaning the ice. For Flower, I mean, you saw his reaction on the bench. I mean, everybody, they went right to the
that was awesome.
Right to Flower on the bench. The excitement of it. Was there a time, or was he just watching you? And you said it was kind of with Kirill jumping on the ice. How does that work? Because a lot of times you see in a game, the goaltender's looking, but he doesn't get the nod, and then he looks to see what's going on, and he's missing the actual timing. Was that perfect for you?
Yeah, it was good. Well, you know, he kind of asked when we told him. We just said, Flower, we got to get 2 points. So, you know, we're probably going to pull the goalie and, you know, a little bit later in the kill. So just be attentive and be ready. And then, you know, there was a face-off just prior to that. And the guys were like, are we going to do it now? And we said, no, just wait a second. And then Flower was attentive. And then once Kirill gained possession, you know, he circled up the ice. Then when he circled the second time, I think if you watch the play too, he nods to Flower, like, let's go. And Flower was halfway out. And you know, Flower's, I think, attentiveness, to your point, was critical in the play as well.
Well, it's an exciting finish against a team that you're trying to chase there in those Western Conference wild card positions. And, I mean, I guess, Coach, the question I have is, what is it going to take to get this team into that postseason position? And what do you think, you know, you need more of right now at this point with the regular season quickly coming to an end soon?
Yeah, I think a couple of things. You know, really the last three games, we've gotten great goaltending from, you know, two from Flower, and then Gustafson had a great game against Colorado. So I think if we can continue to get that type of goaltending here down the stretch is going to be critical for us to be able to win games. You know, I think we've been, you know, our top line's been very, very effective for us. I think a little bit more contribution throughout the lineup, a little bit more depth scoring, I think would be important for us. And I think if we can have that combination, if we can get the goaltending that we've got in the last three games, I think then it's up to the rest of us, you know, coaches and players, to be able to find ways to win games and try to push guys to their max capacity individually and collectively as a team. And I think if you do that, we're going to give ourselves a good chance to make a run here down the stretch and let the chips fall where they may.
It can't be easy. You lost your captain due to injury, and Kaprizov's been hurt a bunch. And we could talk about your roster, but that was so much fun to watch. I got to know, what other coaches texted you after that? You don't have to tell us what they said, but you had to get some messages.
There was a few coaches. Can't coach in fear. And then there was other text messages that I probably couldn't say on the air. But, yeah, it was kind of like what you guys were talking about. It's, you know, I think guys were, you know, and then other coaches too, like, it's a great decision because it worked, right? So that's also, you know, one of the things too is you get, you know, we're talking today, but I, you know, I've been in other situations too where you make decisions and it doesn't work out. And when the players come through, I think when you believe in the players and their abilities, and then they have the opportunity to come through, and you believe that they can do certain things in certain situations, I'm just happy that those guys were rewarded for the execution that they put in the situation.
John, this was quite a game, not just a victory, but Flower had a tremendous save in this game. And you know, you've been on many benches, you've seen many teams. When a goaltender makes a huge stop, how the bench just kind of just wow and just goes from there. So he makes a huge stop. Then you pull your goaltender. I mean, the emotion in the building and in the, you know, on the bench must have really been something at the end of the game with what, you know, what transpired throughout this game as we're watching this tremendous stop by Flower.
Yeah, it certainly was. And that's, you know, I think it's even before the game, you could just, like, it was a great crowd. The building was buzzing pretty well. And, you know, that's what Flower's done for us. Like, he's been amazing. You know, he makes key saves. And I think when you look at a guy like his career and where he's at in his career, just the way that he competes and battles and the passion that he plays the game with, it's certainly inspiring to the team. And he's, you know, like I said, this whole situation maybe doesn't get talked about if Flower doesn't make that save. And then I think the execution of everything that goes on, where you can set up a plan, but the players are the guys that go out on the ice and do it. And it's it was a crazy, exciting time. But, you know, for the guys to be as dialed in as they were and execute in that time with all the fans going crazy and kind of the time in the game was really something to be proud of.
All right, so you got to tell us, and a lot of coaches, you know, you lay out your game plan, you set up your plays off face-offs, and then they always go to the bench right away, and the coach is just like, there's no fist pumps, there's no high fives. It's like, yeah, okay, congrats, good job, guys, good job. Like, was there a fist pump? Like, they didn't see it right away. You guys must be like,
this is, hold on. I mean, it's former team too.
Yeah, I know, but you guys must have been like, yes, like, come on, we did it. Like, that worked. Like, there must have been a little more emotion than, because you don't want to show, because you know the camera's going to be on you.
Oh yeah.
And it's like, oh, handshakes around. Yeah, great job. Going down the tunnel, you must have been like high five and everything in the building.
Oh yeah. Well, no, for sure. It was great. Then you have actually some of the extra guys that weren't playing in the game. They came flying out of the change room and they were in the locker room. And, you know, we were talking and like, what the heck happened here? I'm like, thank God we scored.
Unreal.
A different story if we didn't. Well, hey, Coach, we appreciate you taking the time joining us last minute here to talk about that game and that decision. And we wish you the best of luck as you try to get into that postseason.
All right. Thank you. It's always, thanks for having me. It was great catching up again.